No items, Fox only, final destination. If you're at all familiar with Smash, chances are you've heard some variant of this saying at least once. It's a classic meme that's meant to jokingly signify that things have gotten serious. And ever since Smash's inception back in 1999, things really have been serious. Smash has spawned a huge competitive scene, with players from all around the globe competing to be the best of the best. From Smash 64 and Melee, to Smash 4 and Ultimate, although there have been some bumps along the way, Smash has enjoyed a long and storied competitive history that continues to this day. Ironically enough, it seems that this seemingly simple party game has become better known for its competitive scene than anything else, with an abundance of combo videos, tournament sets, and compilations populating the internet. Given this, I thought it would be fun to focus on the complete opposite side of Smash for this video, the casual side. More specifically, I wanted to talk about what I think is the most fun Smash game to play casually. To be completely honest with you, I've really struggled with writing this script. I've been through 3 or 4 iterations already, trying to explain my viewpoint with almost scientific precision. But after a while, I thought it would be better to just talk, and be a little bit less analytical, and just get my thoughts out there. As a result, this video might be a bit rambly, a bit unorganized. But at this point, I think it's better to voice my thoughts in a bit of a messy way than keep them to myself and keep prolonging this video's release. If you've seen some of my previous videos, you may already be able to predict what I'm gonna say. I'll admit that I am a bit biased here, but I hope that you'll hear me out regardless. Whether you're a hardcore Smash player, a casual, or anything in between, I hope you'll stick around as I talk about the pinnacle of casual Smash. I've been playing Smash Bros. For as long as I can remember. I started with the original on the N64, despite growing up in a time where Melee existed. And let me tell you, I played this game for an ungodly amount of time. Every time I would get together with my cousins, we would bust out Smash 64 and play it until we were sick of the game. This tradition would continue with the subsequent games in the franchise. Melee, Brawl, Smash 4, and of course, Ultimate. This wasn't limited to just family reunions either. The same thing happened when I would hang out with my friends. Every time there was some kind of get-together, it was guaranteed that Smash would make an appearance. And while there definitely was a spirit of competition in the air, it was hardly ever the focus. The vast majority of the time spent was us just playing to have fun, going for those ridiculous spikes that would cost you a stock, Ganon and Bowser sides, cargo carries off stage, items. It was all just to have a good time. Needless to say, I feel like I have a pretty good idea of what makes casual Smash an enjoyable experience. And throughout the years, I've noticed that when it comes to the spirit of fun, one game stood out from the rest. And it may not be the one you had in mind. It feels like Smash 4 is in a bit of a strange position. When you take a broad look at the series, each entry is something that makes it special. Smash 64 was the pioneer, the first. Melee introduced an awesome adventure mode, as well as Special Smash, stadium games and more, while also being the go-to official entry for competitive play. Brawl had the Subspace Emissary, arguably one of the most beloved modes in the franchise, and Smash Ultimate speaks for itself. It brands itself as the ultimate Smash. It has the most characters, the most stages, the most music, the most ways to play. That just leaves Smash 4. What makes it special? Is it the fact that it released on 2 consoles? The fact that it brought back old characters? Perhaps the DLC? The thing is, everything that Smash 4 can do, Ultimate can do better. Everything, that is. Except for one thing. Custom's greatest claim to fame was probably being swiftly banned from competitive play way back in the day, with the argument being that they were completely busted, an argument that just so happens to be 100% correct. Kong Cyclone, Tripping Tree, Power Counters, Wizard's Dropkick, Gust Cape, Custom Moves, were broken. And believe it or not, the moves were just half of the equation. Combine these moves with ludicrous stat-enhancing equipables, and you get one of the most hectic, illogical, ridiculous messes to ever grace a Smash game. And I love it. When customs are enabled, shields are just a suggestion. Any percent is kill percent. One grab can spell your doom. And some moves are all but guaranteed. Customs truly are the embodiment of chaos. Anything can happen at any moment, and it feels like half the time nobody even knows what's going on. It's this descent into madness that I think brings out the absolute best of what Smash Bros. Has to offer. And it's why Smash 4 has earned the title of Best Casual Smash Game in my books. It was an ultimate, unrestrained KO Fest. It was a party game, in the purest sense of the word. I could try to explain in further detail why customs are so incredibly fun and silly. But, as they say, show, don't tell. As much as I would have liked to end it there, there's something that I just can't avoid mentioning. It's finally time for me to address the elephant in the room. When spirits were unveiled, I was actually pretty surprised. It became immediately obvious to me that this was the spiritual successor to customs. I wholeheartedly expected the Smash team to completely scrap the idea, seeing as how sometimes it felt like my friends and I were the only ones who used them. I was pretty excited to try them out when they were first announced. But soon after release, that excitement sort of faded away. Spirits are pretty underwhelming. I realize that this is in part due to my own expectations. All you need to do is look at some of the reactions to DLC fighters to see that expectation can play a huge role in how you receive something. But while it's true that you can still do some fun stuff with spirits, and I've had a relatively good time using them, they just don't feel the same. And I think the reason why is simple. They tried to balance them. See, with customs, everything had a trade-off. Raising attack lowered defense. Raising defense lowered speed. And raising speed lowered attack. This led to extreme situations where you could KO someone in one hit, but also be KO'd in a similar manner. You could become an unstoppable tank, but have a jump so low that one throw off stage would spell your doom. Or you could be a speed demon that could dance around your opponent, but do pitiful amounts of damage and knockback. With spirits, this dynamic isn't present. Every spirit gives you both attack and defense, so any attack you might gain is offset by the amount of defense an opponent has, leading to much more subdued interactions. On top of this, there's an effectiveness triangle a la Fire Emblem, where certain spirit types are stronger or weaker against others. This, more than anything, is just a nuisance, as it can really make it an uphill battle if your opponent has a type advantage. Equipping neutral spirits can help remedy the problem, but doing so also limits the selection at your disposal. Overall, while I still think playing with spirits is fun, I think the way they've been implemented misses the point of why customs were so enjoyable in the first place. The fact that they were unbalanced. If I had to guess why it was done like this, I'd say the devs were probably worried about World of Light becoming too frustrating. So they tried to even out the implementation, to provide the adventure mode with a more consistent experience. But in doing so, I think they made spirits much more bland than their predecessor. At the end of the day, everything I've said is just my opinion. I hope I don't come off as an elitist, or make it sound like I hate everything but Smash 4, because nothing could be further from the truth. I love this franchise, and I love each game for different reasons. I'm pretty curious to know what you guys think. Do you agree with me? Or do you find that you had more fun with a different game? Feel free to leave your thoughts in the comments. As for me, while other games in the series may be more nostalgic, have better options, or have tighter controls, I think none are simply as much of a joy to play as Smash 4 with customs. And while Smash 4 may not be the pioneer, the innovator, the nostalgia trip, or the ultimate, and while it may not even be remembered too fondly by a lot of people, I'd like to remember it for at least being one thing. Fun. This has been the GioDude. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.